Catherine, you'll be the first Australian woman to be trained as an astronaut by an international space agency.
How cool.
I mean, what does it mean for you to hold that kind of title?
Oh, I'm absolutely thrilled. This is such an incredible experience and opportunity. I've wanted to be an astronaut ever since I was a little girl, but I never thought I'd ever have the chance to do it as an Australian. So for me, that means so much. And I'm excited for this opportunity to show what Australia is capable of on the world stage, not just me, but all of Australian research and ingenuity, because it's the scientists and engineers that create the experiments that astronauts ultimately operate up there, and that's what I'll be training to learn how to do.
It is very cool, the European Space Agency. I went there for a 60 Minutes story and I remember saying just that it's so immersive, and you're right about representing Australia because that's something that's new, but also just seeing a female astronaut, I mean, that's something you don't see every day.
Yeah, astronauts that are women are absolutely still in the minority, so I really hope to use this opportunity to demonstrate to young Australian women in particular that there's not just a place for them in STEM, but that they can really thrive and have compelling careers in it too. In Australia, when I grew up, we didn't even have a space agency, and now we have a thriving space sector and we're opening doors internationally and doing national missions, and there's so much opportunity. Space is a gateway ultimately to all STEM fields. Mm. I have two little kids. They love dressing up as astronauts.
Yeah.
They wouldn't dress up as a blockchain, right? But they can get excited into all STEM fields through opportunities like this.